bottom, this is Ecclesall Road.
Right.
Now, it's got a real significance, Ecclesall Road, because it's the point where kind of it's a physical boundary. Uh-huh. The other physical boundary is there's an island there, Hanover Way. Now, they actually boxed the area in.
Mm-hmm.
So, this area here is a council estate with the high rise, and this is where a lot of the so-called underworld of Broomhall kind of tend to do their business. It's an area that's populated by families, migrants, English, you know, it's a real dense mix of people.
Yeah.
And it's got a lot of community initiatives, so you've got Tara in there, you've got, we based our offices in there and stuff like that, and, you know, it's if you want to get to a lot of Broomhall people at one time, mm-hmm. that's the place.
That's the crux of it,
yeah.
Right?
Even though it's not seen as that, it's seen as one of the most negative places in the whole area. Running straight right through it is a famous path. It's called Exeter Way. So on Exeter Way, you've had shootings, there's been gang fights, all sorts. And the reason why this area is used so much is because, A, the density of the buildings,
mm-hmm.
The belief by young people that nobody really comes into this area and looks after it and patrols it. So you either get this kind of flood of police or kind of no police whatsoever. It's somewhere that back in the day you would have had a police officer. Yeah. Just for this area.
Right.
Yeah, that would have been the policing style. Now it's kind of flit in, flit out, kind of firefighting kind of style. So it's quite handy for them to kind of hang around here. There's a lot of rat runs. There's a few flats that sell cat. There's a few, there have been crack flats on there and all sorts. So, you know, it's an easy place to hide. But within there, you've got parks, which is a very social place. A lot of people that kind of get to know each other will find out each other about each other on the park in the summer when they're playing with the kids, and it'll start off with, you know, you sitting on one side of the bench, the other sitting on the other, and throughout the month you'll kind of get together because your kids are playing together.
Sure.
So it's a nice place to kind of integrate. Then you've got the shops. And the church. The church is a beautiful building, which is disused.
Is that the St. Silas?
Yeah, and the Church of England pulled out of there some years ago. With the kind of idea that the YMCA was going to take it over and create a new kind of leisure centre, new YMCA, in that building. That hasn't happened. Also, on the corner here is the vicarage. Now, the vicarage was actually earmarked to be a community centre until some community arrest arose.
Right.
And basically, some individuals in the community spoke about some lies about the community centre or the ideas and development of the community centre, and there was a full stop put on that project.
Mm-hmm.
I had gained about £120,000 to put in a facility into Broomhall, and that was one of the places that I was actually looking at potentially to do it. It wasn't the be-all and end-all, but I lost £120,000 just by having a look at that building.
Wow.
So you can see the amount of kind of...
Yeah.
So
there's a lot riding on that one,
though. Yeah, a lot. Yeah. Then you've got William Street, which is one of the most important roads in Broomhall, purely because it's one of the only feeder roads from Hanover Way that let you into the area.
Yeah.
there's only a few ways into Broomhall. There's actually physically about four, maximum five ways onto Broomhall. It's quite a difficult area to get on.
It does
on
seem
on
really
on
enclosed, doesn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah, and especially if you have a car. Well, that was done on purpose because of the prostitution.
They used to reside
in the area. So they kind of blocked off all the routes, you know. Also, it's an area that's held a lot of skirmishes, purely because this corner here is what we call a hangout zone, but it's also a conflict zone. So if you're looking for the smiling boys, then a lot of the time in the summer, they're sitting on the wall outside the church, just chilling. Right. Shops there, so you know, you get your drinks and snacks from there. It's the one of the arches to the community, so you know it's quite convenient to be on this corner here. Plus, it wasn't seen as something quite negative. You know, there was quite visible. You know, when you as a parent going to and from you know the shops or visiting people in the area, could actually see what they was doing. If they're just sitting down, minding their own business, having a laugh, what harm is it?
Exactly.
To some individuals, it seems as quite negative, very negative.
Yes.
So, well, it was just, it served as a gate to Texas Drive.
Gateway into that to the estate sort of part.
Yeah, exactly. So that's you know, it, so then you've got let's take you up to Brunswick Street, about here. You have to kind of cut through a whole load of kind of blocked off streets and stuff like that, but up here you've got Brunswick Street. And Broomstring Lane. Of course, Brunswick Street's very famous for being a conflict zone.
Yeah.
Two shootings on here, drive-by shootings. One led to a auntie getting shrapnel in the face, and the other one led to a fatality.
Yeah.
And on here, you've got the third most used community centre in the city. So it's an important area. It's also a very busy area for students, because the students come down from Sheffield University.
Yes.
But you've also got the Hallam University coming in from the other side, from William Street side. So this area right here is conduit.
Yes.
Into town, into Sharrow, into Exor. You know, it's a very kind of busy place. If you stop there for a minute, you kind of get a sense of the type of people that are coming there now. A lot of people know what this street is about.
Yeah, yeah.
But they feel that it's not a generally dangerous place.
No.
It's a place that is a flashpoint area.
Right.
Rather than a kind of no-go area.
Gotcha, yeah.
So there's a complete difference in mindset. You know, if you're walking through it and whatever, you understand that 95% of the time, there ain't going to be nothing happening.
Exactly.
And it's about you recognising when there is a situation on the street that you should take a detour. Yeah. But that you do have this the security to actually feel, oh, it's all right today. I'm going to use that, because that's the quickest way from A to B.
Yeah. Well, that's interesting. You know, what you were saying last time we spoke was when you've got that feeling when you're coming in from Broomhall Park, is it?
Yeah.
And the leafy suburb sort of area.
Yeah.
So where's the juncture there that you experience?
It's the end of here. There's actually a gatehouse that kind of denotes the, and it leads onto, I can't recall the road name. It's at the end of William Street. It might still be a continuation of William Street.
Yeah.
But there is actually a nursery there. And there's a gatehouse, the old gatehouse there. It's a ridiculously small house that you look at and go, who the hell would live in there? And then, you know, because it seems like a one-bedroom kitchen and you might be able to squeeze a bathroom in type of dwelling. But, you know, when you dig into the history, you realise that it's a gatekeeper's house, and that's why it's so small, and it starts making sense. So that's the borderline. So on this side, you've got care homes, big old houses, care homes for the elderly, big student flat facilities. Mm-hmm. The university have got a lot of facilities this side of the road. Also, there's the big, massive houses.
Yeah.
And you know, like they are regal in the sense of they're all brick, the big, massive bricks. You know, to build them today, you would have to spend a lot of money. And the type of people that live in them seem to be upper middle class.
Yeah.
And upwards. Yeah. You know, the lecturer types, the doctors, you know, people up and coming in their serious professions.
Yes.
So of attitude, the problems actually stop there, really.
Right.
Occasionally, the kids will venture up this area and do street robberies and stuff like that because it's rich pickings and whatever.
Yeah.
But generally, this area is another area that is used as a conduit into the other areas. So you'll see a lot of movement with students and professionals moving in and out of town on this road. And it's another area where, if you think about it, they've got to go past this group as well.
Mm-hmm.
You could actually perceive that as an intimidating road.
Yeah.
If you was that way in tuned.
Mm-hmm.
Or you could see it as I'm passing through an area which is culturally different.
Yes. Yeah.
A lot of people see it as a culturally different area.
Do you think a lot of people are completely unaware of
the
legacy of, you know, those streets too?
I think that the reinforcement of the negative energy is the press and the media that kind of runs with these flashpoint incidents.
Right.